wicked.
This is a UAR 73 kilogram catchweight bout. First of all, introducing your fighters in the blue corner, representing the Grip House from Glasgow. He's a mixed martial art record of 5 wins, 1 loss, and 1 draw. He stands at 6 foot tall, age 31. He weighed in at 71.4 kilograms. Please put your hands together for Jeff Acker. Facing him across the cage is his opponent in the red corner, representing TFT MMA. He's from Sunderland. He's a mixed martial art record of 8 wins, 5 losses, and no draws. He stands also at 6 foot tall, age 21. He weighed in at 72.8 kilograms. Please show some appreciation for Jamie Roper. We're scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds. Your referee, Trevor Mitchell. The action's about to begin.
Crazy to think that, you know, Jamie Roper's only 21 years old. So many amateur fights. He's a very fast starter as well. Jeff Acker looks very relaxed. He needs to be aware of that.
Jeff Acker just loves to dance, doesn't he?
He does.
Here we go. That elusive movement of Jeff Acker.
He looks so relaxed.
As always. It's such fluent movement. It's...
Yeah.
It's something that is hard to replicate in a training partner.
Oh, lovely head kick as well. Yeah, it's very unique, he's, you know, his approach. Does have a solid top game though, this is where he wants the fight. Jamie's definitely the more accomplished striker. Jamie does have good submission skills as well though.
What benefit does Jamie have with his teammate Jack Hardy having previously fought, Jeff?
Well, you know, Jack can obviously give him first-hand experience of what it's like in the cage with him. And I'm sure obviously he's been watching the footage as well, watching that one back. But ultimately, you know, as I say, people improve in the gym a lot. There's been a lot of time between that fight. You're never going to know what to expect.
Very much like the Jeff Acker we've seen against Marcus Shanks here, pinning his man up against the cage, not giving him an inch to move.
Yeah, you know, as compromising as this position may look, Jamie has been in this position a million times, you know. This is what the majority of his opponents are trying to do to him, grind him out.
Oh, Roper there away from the cage, looking to bring down some strikes. But Acker didn't get his hooks in here.
Yeah, he's got like the hooks in behind the knees. But he's going to look to get them on the inside of the legs.
Roper just staying calm here, as you say. There, the hook in
yeah,
now.
Yeah, he's got one hook in. Looks Jamie's going to look to shake him off.
A little bit heavy there on the top. Not an ideal position for either man, this.
No. Jamie has potential of getting out on top. But Jeff's staying strong.
And as you say, it happens. Jamie Roper finds himself in top position now.
Jamie looks like he's looking for a Kimura. He's in good position here. If he can, yes, he's going for it.
Looking up,
Jeff's strong though, Jeff's very strong.
Very impressive strength.
Jamie can't get carried away here. Here we go, he's ended up on bottom.
Corner for hammer fist. Again, difficult position that both men find themselves
yeah.
in. Very much a 50-50 sort of unorthodox.
Jeff could come up on the mount here, but Jamie has some upper body control, which is preventing him from doing that.
Difficult position to get out of. Jeff Acker here just chipping away with a couple of body shots to the side of Jamie Roper.
That round flew.
It didn't it? It was crazy.
Yeah.
Again though, another difficult one to score.
Yeah, for sure.
Men receiving their corner advice here again. Two tremendous gyms, Grip House and TFT for Jeff Acker and Jamie Roper respectively.
We haven't seen a lot of kicks from Jamie Wilbur, which is something we normally see. Maybe that's because, you know, he's expecting the takedown from Jess.
Here we go, round two of schedule three. Jeff Acker, black shorts, black gloves. Jamie Wilbur, black cruise shorts with the outside pink trim. Nice inside leg kick, just as you called it there. Didn't see many, so he fires on straight in.
Jeff's using that side kick to the leg. Very uncomfortable when they land.
John Jones-esque.
Yeah. Can you imagine he's drilled that a lot with Dean Riley leading up to this fight? Good way of keeping your range and keeping your distance from your opponent.
Both men, this is very much like what we've seen in that last bout where both men know the power each other possesses. So it's very tentative work on the feet. It's lots of feints.
Yeah.
Trading kicks there.
Jeff is standing southpaw. Oh, and he lands the rear leg nicely there.
Big front kick up the middle from Jeff Acker.
Jeff staying nice and busy with his kicks. He's keeping Jamie guessing. Jamie stalking him. Oh, lovely. Very good with that combination. Left hook, right hand. Jeff changes levels.
Looking for that takedown again against the cage. Jamie doing a good job of defending this though.
Yeah, Jamie nice and low with his hips. He's going to look to try and work an underhook, get his feet back on the floor.
As I said previously, this is very much like what we've seen against Marcus Shanks from Jeff Acker. Just that persistent forward pressure. Grind your man against the cage until that takedown comes.
Yeah, Jeff Acker can do this all day. Jamie very flexible.
Good work from Rupert to get back up on his feet straight away.
Yeah. Heavy pressure low from Jeff Acker. He's wearing at Jamie's legs with those knees.
How much does that pressure take it out of you?
Oh, it's exhausting. You know, you're carrying someone else's weight when you're already, you know, taking deep breaths. So it can definitely definitely weighs up as the fight goes on.
Jeff Acker gets a drag. Jeff Acker. But Jamie Roper straight back to his feet.
Yeah, Jamie's like a cat.
Big foot stomp from Acker.
Jamie needs to try and turn into him. He's fighting the hands. Jeff does a good job of switching sides. Tell he's very experienced on the wall.
He's so quick as well when he does it.
Yeah, very subtle.
Seconds to go here in this second round. Acker looking to tie up the arms of Roper. Both men throwing quite unorthodox kicks there to end that round out.
Jeff using his strength advantage in that round, making Jamie carry his weight.
Three minutes to go here to decide a winner.
I think we might need to see something big from Jamie. Don't get me wrong, the rounds have been close. But I think Jeff's just edged the both rounds so far. We know Jamie's capable of finishing the fight. You know, he's very, very dangerous striker, very good on the ground as well. But he's going to have to pull the trigger and he's going to have to, you know, come forward in this round.
Is this back to what we've seen in the previous fight, where it's almost a case of you need to take a risk to try and advance a position?
100%, 100%.
Corners are out, here we go. 3 minutes to go to decide the winner. Jamie runs across to shake hands. Jeff Acker says after the fight. And we're underway here. Third and final round in this one. 73 kilogram catch weight. Acker goes up top with the kick. Off the gloves of Jamie Roper though.
Jamie needs to let his kicks go. Jeff's started the round southpaw. And that's why.
Twice now he's throwing that kick upstairs. catches Jamie's kick there. Jamie looks to try and fire it back out, just misses.
Jeff again, southpaw, might be looking to throw that back leg again. Oh, but Jamie
throws
Jamie beats
zone.
Him to it. Nice clean shot there, across the ribs.
How difficult is that constant movement to fight against?
It's just awkward, yeah. Like you're kind of expecting something if you commit to coming forward. So it can be very off-putting. Jamie just needs to, forget about that. Just take risks now. Come forward. Let his hands and let his kicks go.
Both men seem to have plenty left as well in the gas tank.
Jeff finds himself again on this rear body lock. Jamie moves himself to the cage for a little bit of support.
Jeff looking to take the back there, but Jamie straight back up to his feet.
Jeff gets the takedown. Jamie's pushing the head away, looking to get up to his feet immediately.
Just another grindy performance here. It takes so much out of you having this constant work, constant.
Yeah, very exhausting type of fight.
Go on.
Something that Jeff has kind of became acclimatized to, though. Like he's developed this type of style. John Fitch used to do it to people, and like you could see them getting frustrated in the fight.
With the pressure as well, it's not like a striking bout where you have them a couple of seconds every now and again to fill your lungs with air. You're constantly working here. You take half a second off and you can find yourself on the mat.
Yeah. Just when Jamie's getting comfortable on the feet, committing to big strikes, Jeff commits to the clinch and most times gets the takedown. Oh, nice Granby there from Jamie. Jeff still on top though.
Jeff working to the back and it's all over. And that did not feel like 3-3s at all. That was very quick.
Yeah, Jamie not happy with his performance. Very tough fight.
And look, it's as we said, like Jamie never doesn't fight top guys.
That's it, and he didn't take any big shots. Jamie could probably fight next week. It's just stylistically, Jeff was able to impose his game plan and grind it out.
I imagine we're about to see the dance moves of Jeff Acker now.
Yeah, cue the music.
Ladies and gents, another fantastic fight. Please put your hands together for both of our warriors inside the cage. After three hard-fought, three-minute rounds, we go to your judges' scorecard. We have a unanimous decision in favour of the blue corner, Jeff Acker! Also, let's hear for your runner-up, Jamie Roper!
Jeff Acker gets the win, as expected on the scorecards.
Unorthodox entrance, unorthodox dancing, unorthodox finish.
Yeah. Unique celebration, but I don't think we've seen the end of it yet.
It's very, very good.
Yes, especially, considering, he hasn't had that many amateur fights. But he always comes, he always manages to, fight the way he wants to fight.
I feel these moves are coming very, very soon. Look, I think Jeff's going to cause a lot of problems for a lot of people.
For sure, and you've got to think when he goes to pro, he's going to be able to utilise elbows on top and stuff as well.
I'd quite like to see Jeff in an IMAP tournament.
Yes. Yeah, that would be very good. Very, I think you'd do quite well.
Of course, the Scottish Mixed Martial Arts Federation recently just set up now as well. Ian Feenan and James Doolan, I believe, at the helm of that. And look, the World Championships are happening, what, this week? George Staines, of course. Worry amateur out of England becoming the European champion. I'd very, very much like to see Jeff Acker